Okay, let's get started. We'll open a web browser and make sure you have VirtualBox installed, just to make sure. And it's at virtualbox.org. And you go on the left side where it says Downloads, and just pick the Windows hosts, and it's 64-bit and 32-bit, okay, just to make sure you have that. Once that's downloaded, make sure you install it, and it's not very hard to do. Next up is Arch Linux, of course, and that's archlinux.org right here. There's some issues right now, but we'll deal with that later. I highly recommend the wiki, and notably the there it is, beginner's guide. This will tell you everything you need to know and give you pointers on installing Arch Linux. This is what I used, and it's very, very, very in-depth and thorough. So take a look through that as you go along installing. Now we'll go to download section here, and that's on archlinux.org/download. And there's two formats. There's a net install and a core image. We're going to use the core image, which is download. Now there's three types. There's a 32-bit, 64-bit, or both of them, the dual. So we're going to use the dual one. These links here point to torrents, so if you don't want to use a torrent, or can't use torrent, whatever, or BitTorrent, there's HTTP direct downloads, and they start at Australia in alphabetical order down to, zoom out, Vietnam. So just for example, I'll pick a mirror, and we want the dual, the core dual, which is approximately 700 megabytes or so. So you click that. And if you're, depending on your browser, it'll start downloading. Okay. You can see here. So it's going to take a while depending on your connection. And once you have that downloaded, we'll fire up VirtualBox after you have that installed. And we'll start proceeding with installing Arch Linux in VirtualBox. Okay, we have our Oracle VirtualBox running. And we're going to install Arch Linux. So select New from the big button here. And click Next. And it's asking for a name. So just type in capital A and an Arch, like Arch. And as soon as you do that, it selects Arch Linux for you. And we're using 64. And it'll select 64. I'll put dash bit. If you're not using 64-bit, don't put that in, this part here. But we're using 64, so click Next. I'm going to give it a gig of RAM, 1024 megabytes, and click Next. And VDI, that's fine, Next. Dynamically allocated, Next. And give it a bit more. I'm going to give it quite a bit more. I'm going to give it 30 gigabytes. You can drop that down to maybe to 10, but you're pushing it there if you do that. So Next, then Create, and then finally Create once more. And now we just press Start and hit Next. And now we're not going to use a CD-ROM, okay? We're just going to use the image we downloaded, which is the Arch 2011-08-19 Core Dual ISO. You just hit Open and then Next, and then you start. And it should start with the boot screen. And if you're using 32-bit, it would be this one. If you're using 64, which I am, it'll be this one. So use the arrow key up and down to choose, or if you want to power off, say forget it, you can do that. Okay, so 64-bit. Hit Enter, and it loads. Done. And to begin installing, just run Arch Setup. Actually, it's a slash. So we'll type that in, slash Arch. That's down here, by the way. That's, and setup. And hit Enter. And where it says OK, just press Enter. Select your source. Of course, we're using local, right? So we're not using internet. So you enter for OK. Set your editor. Yeah. Nano is the easiest one to use. So we'll just hit OK, and we'll talk about that a bit later. Set clock. Hit OK. Select your region. And then Americas, wherever you are, hit OK. UTC is fine, so you press Enter. And check the time. If it looks like it's, you know, the right date and the right time and the right year, you just press Enter to return. And now we go again to the main menu. Now I'm going to prepare the hard drive. And this part's going to, I'm going to do the second option, manual partition of the hard drives. Okay, the reason I'm doing this is because if you want to install this on your system, you're going to have to do this. If you're using a partition, the hard drive, you're going to dual boot with another OS like Windows or another Linux distro. So we only have one hard drive here, so you select /dev/device/SDA1 and hit OK, which is pressing Enter, and Enter again. And you just, to navigate here, you just press the left and the right arrow keys, okay? And we'll hit New. It's going to be Primary. To clear that screen, let me get the cursor, where it says Size in Megabytes, you just hit Backspace. And this is going to be our boot. I'm going to give it 512 megabytes. That's a little large, but Okay. It's large for a boot, but that's fine. So you press Enter when you're done at the beginning. And we'll mark it bootable. And arrow right until you say get to type. And press Enter. And at the bottom where it says Enter File System, we're going to type in 83. And it's a Linux file system. Okay, now we arrow down, and we're going to create a new. And this one's going to be a logical partition, okay? Again, backspace, and this is going to be our, we have boot, root drive, sorry. So this will be our root partition, which will be fairly large. It'll be 10, 2, 3 gigabytes. We press Enter at the beginning of that partition, and the type is 83. Press Enter. Okay, now we're going to say another new one. Primary. This will be your swap, and we don't need very much, so 256 megabytes. That's going to be at the end. And I'm going to have to arrow down because we have free space on the next one, but because it's at the bottom, arrow down, and type is 82. Oops, I better do that again. Sorry. So I'll just type it in anyway. 82, press Enter. And then you can see it says primary Linux swap. Okay, and then we'll arrow up one more. Okay, new, again, primary. The rest of this space is your space, your home. So it's 20-some gigabytes. And again, it's type, Enter, and it's going to be 83 again, Enter. And I'll arrow up. I don't know if you have to do that. And I'll just hit right where it's highlighted, and you just type in yes. And that's it. And we just arrow till we say quit. And arrow down, say done. Step 3 is to manually configure the block device file systems and mount points. Okay, so when we hit enter on option 3, it's going to ask you what you want to do. So we're going to pick the first option by device. So we press enter for OK. And you notice the three part, can't count today. Four partitions, one, and they're kind of numbered funny, but don't worry about it. So the first one is 486 megabytes. That's our boot partition. Yes, and since it's not generalizing or anything like that for boot, we're going to use extension 2, the second option. Press OK. And that's our boot. So make sure you select that for booting. And we'll name it boot. Oops, not new boot. The second option you can leave blank. This one is, that's our swap file, second one, okay? You have to keep track, you know, like you can tell by the size, basically. So this is our swap, yes, and swap, and just name it swap, and press enter, okay, leave that blank, and okay. Arrow down, and that's the largest one, and if you remember, that's our home. So now we're going to do generalizing extension 4. Home. Call it home. Enter. And then enter again. Finally, the last one there is our root. And that's going to be extension 4 again. And root, first option. And we'll type in root. Enter. Enter. And we'll say done. And it should create the partitions for you, and then we'll have to move on to installing the system. So make sure this goes through. And hit OK, and then you hit, sorry, one more time, OK to return to the main menu, and step 5 is to select the packages. Okay, so we hit enter to select packages. You can read through that. It's split up into 3 different sections. So we'll use Grub. That's well-known bootloader. Now, it asks you if you want to install Base. Yes. And Base Developer or Devel. So to select anything to like that in the between the brackets, the squares brackets, you just hit the space bar and the little star appears. That means it's going to install. So when you're done, you press Enter for OK. Only thing we need here, not the only thing, but in this instance is sudo. If you ran Ubuntu or other, so, you know, you're familiar with that. And here's one thing, okay? With a wireless, we don't need this in VirtualBox because it's like a, it looks like a connected, wired connection anyway. But if you have wireless, please make sure you select wireless tools. So you highlight that. But I don't need that. We don't need that for now. So you just press enter. I don't think there's anything really that's... Okay, bash is already... Yeah, there's some stuff that's pre-selected. So you press OK. And next step is to install packages. Press enter. Tells it's going to begin. Press enter for OK. And checking integrity. Okay, then I... When you're done with that, just press enter to continue. And next up is to configure the system. Okay, so configure the system. We're getting close here. This gives you the opportunity to look over some important files. rc.config. You just press enter, and this will open in that editor that was before called Nano. And to navigate through Nano, use your arrow keys. And everything that has a pound sign, the number sign beside it, is commented out, so it means it's not going to run. It's just a message or whatever. One thing that you could do, go down, yeah, I can't use the mouse scroll yet, okay, is under hostname, just like in, you know, any other like installation, you can call it anything you want. So we're using Pac-Man, so we call it Pac, just anything you like. And we're using Nano, so we'll just call it Pac Nano, and that's it. You just leave it there. You don't have to press enter or anything. Now, when we get to interface, internet part, the network part, further down, where it says interface equals, in VirtualBox, it's Ethernet 0, number 0, and for wireless, it would be... WLAN 0, usually. So anyway, Ethernet, UTH 0. And the rest should be okay. Yeah, we don't have to worry about daemons yet. So to write this out, you press Control X, and then you want to answer yes. So you just press Y because you want to save the changes, and you press Enter, and we're done. File System tab, go down. You can look at your Pac-Man configuration. And the main thing, if you're using 64-bit, is to uncomment. Let me get my mouse here. This section, multi-lib, and also the include. Okay. And the number sign, pound sign, just press delete. Arrow down and press delete. That's it. Control X, Y, and press enter. Okay, mirrorless. This is where you get your updates and packages from. So you select your country. There's a whole bunch of them here. So you can leave your country name commented out. That's fine. But you want to get the server. So you just delete, arrow down, delete. If it looks fine to you, you just press Control X again, Y, enter. Finally, set a root password. Make that accepted that, and then arrow down, say done. Install the bootloader. For Windows, if you're dual booting, you want to uncomment title root and make active. But we're not going to do that for there. Just in case, I'll press Control X. And we have one hard drive, so you press OK. Grub installed successfully. And we're done. We've installed Arch Linux. And that's the end of part one.